Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart FM and welcome back to the Wrexham Low League save for Football Manager 2016. As always, we start off on the schedule and it's been a bit of an unfortunate series of events the last few games. We had the Chester game in the last Livecom. We won 2-0, it was a fantastic result and we were riding high at the top of the table. We then played Tranmere, who are a very good team at this level, only recently got relegated to the Conference. And we drew 0-0. It was a game which was quite boring, actually. Nothing really happened. Nothing really worth showing here. And then we followed that up with a good away win to Dover, although I did think at one stage we were going to lose that game. But fortunately, we held on. We won 4-3. Corey Francis getting his first goal for the club. Jake Beasley on the score sheet as well. An own goal. And Adriano Moke. A couple of players scored for them. Another own goal this time, Manny Smith as well. But we held on 4-3. And that was great. But since then, we've had two 1-0 defeats. First, at home to, I think it's pronounced Geisley or Gaisley. I'm not quite sure if I pronounced that right or wrong. But if you know how to pronounce it, then by all means, let me know in the comment section below. Maybe phonetically let me know, because obviously being a Welsh person and being used to Welsh names, sometimes English names can throw me off sometimes. So it's nice to kind of get that out of the way. And then Woking, which is the game just played just before I started recording, we lost 1-0 to a penalty. And to be honest with you, we should have won. We hit the crossbar. Carrington hit the post. And then Connor Jennings missed late on. It was absolutely a diabolical play. And we should have done a lot better. But anyway, that's the recap of the games. If I show you the league table quickly as well, on the left-hand side here, we're still second. We're still up there. Only 4 points off Braintree. But as you can see, Braintree have won one game more than us, drawn one game more than us, and have lost two less than us. They are riding high at the top of the table and doing well. But we have a game today against Stamford, of all teams. Now, if you're a big Football Manager person that you're watching, I'm assuming you are because you're watching me play Football Manager, there's a great YouTuber that I watch called StatApp, and he has done a fantastic series on Stamford called The Stamford Struggle. I recommend checking it out. I checked out last year. He's still playing it now. The save is going to go up until Christmas, apparently. So he basically took over Stamford, who were in a lower league club, even lower than Wrexham, and transformed them into a Champions League winning team. It was absolutely phenomenal. Anyway, we go up to today's game. I'm going to try and give Liam Sharp a game in goals. We are against lower league opposition, so I can afford to rotate slightly. I'm going to rotate my left back here. Rob Evans, Carrington, do I want to go with that? Madka Gomez can probably come in for Evans. I'll keep Carrington in. He's been doing pretty well. He's been one of my unsung heroes this season for me. You know, I think Adam Smith could possibly play. Who have I got on the bench? Dominic, Wes York. I'm going to give Wes York a game. I haven't played him all season. He can make his first appearance for me. I think I got James Gray as well. Again, I'm going to play him on the right. I want to give players a chance to impress me and to show me what they can do and why they should be in this team. So I'm going to do that, and we're going to submit this team. I'm quite happy to... I can't put Liam Sharp in. I can't put him in goals. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay, let's put Cameron Belford in and swap. We'll have the other keeper in, and that will do. Proceed to match. I want to give him a chance while also keeping the team fairly strong. And of course, I got the substitutes I can bring on then, should I need to. Some decent subs on there. Beasley, Evans, Sutton. So should be okay. No advice we can apply. Encourage the players. I'm definitely going to be encouraging them. Go out there and impress me. And here we go, guys. So that's just as we sort of set things up here and the match gets going. I just want to say thank you to all of you that have given support to my channel recently. We are a fairly new channel, although the channel's been going for over a year now. This is actually my second channel. My first channel is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. But this channel is exclusively for Football Manager content. Like I said, it's my second channel, so the uploads won't probably be as frequent. It'll be like every other day or every 2 days sort of thing. This episode should be up on Friday, if not probably Saturday at the latest. So good evening, good afternoon, good morning for those of you watching. Football Manager is a series that's close to my heart, and I'm really pleased I can actually play this and share this with you. It felt more appropriate to have a channel specifically for it. And Gray's with a chance there. He's missed that. That was a terrible, terrible miss by Gray. And that's why you're not starting games for me, because you're missing chances like that, James Gray. That was appalling. And this is a cup game, obviously, the FA Cup second round, I think this was. So we just want to try and get to the third round, I think. There's a chance we'd be against a bigger team in the third round. It'd be nice to get a cup run going, to be honest. You know, be that kind of giant slaying type of team. Wrexham, of course, got a very cool history with the FA Cup. They actually knocked out Arsenal. I believe it was 1988 or 89. It was the late 80s. They knocked Arsenal out of the FA Cup. Arsenal, who are, I think, they're the record holder for the most FA Cup wins. So, phenomenal stuff. Great giant slaying there. And they're up there in English and Welsh football folklore for that. So, it's fantastic stuff. I don't like this. Stamford coming forward now. Hall plays it into Smith. Gets a shot away, it's blocked, and Logan can pick up. Logan, who's come in for the last few games, have been resting some of my other players, and I've had some injuries as well, obviously, so it's important to have a squad that I can trust and rotate. And that's a bad ball, and it's been cleared by Nathan Fox. Goes out for... So I don't want a replay. I mean, okay, it's nice to have a replay, have the chance to qualify and go through to the next round, but I really don't want to have a replay when I've got 46 league games, plus other cup games, like the Conference Cup. What's it called, the Conference Cup? Not JD, that's the wrong one, that's the Welsh Cup, the JD. You know, I've actually lost what it's called now. But the conference teams play for, we've got that, we have the league, we have lots and lots of, you know, games that we have to play. We had a big pre-season as well, played quite a lot of friendlies, so I don't want to be overusing my players. That's a good shot, and it's in, and York has scored. Where's York? Repays my faith by playing him, by scoring for Wrexham. Stamford 0, Wrexham 1. Where's York with the goal on the 30th minute? A great right-footed strike. Oh, that was great. I'm glad he scored, because I always get a bit nervous when... I'm going to skip that because you just saw it. I get quite nervous when I put players in that haven't played for me all season, but he's repaid my faith straight away with a goal. Corey Francis getting an assist as well. There's another young Welsh player that I'm looking at the moment called Curtis March. He's a former Swansea City and Cardiff City youngster, but he never played an actual professional game for either club. I think he's about 21 or 22 years of age now. He's currently playing in the Welsh Premier League with Port Talbot. Good ball in. Oh, Gray, you're doing crap, Gray. That's twice now. Plays for Port Talbot in the Welsh Premier League. And his scout report says that he's about a 3.5-star rated centre midfielder. But he can also play attacking midfield, and that would be a great position for me, because I need to have more options, because I'm probably playing Carrington a bit too much, even though, oh, it's a good ball, and I thought that was in, and it didn't go in, and unfortunately, it stays 1-0, not 2-0. Damn it, I can't believe that. Fifey's on a yellow card as well, I'm going to have to watch that. Yeah, like I was saying, Curtis March, he can play centre midfield, he can play attacking midfield. 3.5-star rated player, according to my first scout report. I've set my scout to scout him for another month, because we're not in the transfer window yet, so I know I can afford to scout him for another month or two, and that's headed back to Knight, the goalkeeper. But I need options, because I got Carrington, who's really a right-back, but his second position is centre midfield, and he can play defensive midfield, although he's not exactly suited to it. I got Rob Evans, who can play centre midfield and defensive, but he's a little bit awkward defensively. I mean, he can play it, but he's not the best. I got Lee Fowler, who's defensive midfield mainly, but he's only a 2-star player. And then I got Corey Francis, who's a CAM. He's really an attacking midfielder, not really a central midfielder. So I'm a little bit short on permanent kind of centre midfielders. I got Matt Gomez, obviously, but he's only on loan. I like to bring in players that I can develop myself. And if he's 21, 22 years of age, then obviously that's the right sort of age I'm looking for. Players who are young enough to go straight into the first team, but good enough to improve and be a decent sort of League 2 player, or possibly even a League 1 player if they're that good. So that's just some of my transfer news to you there that I'm thinking of doing. I got some decent players on the bench I can bring on, like Beasley and Smith. That's a good ball in for Smith of their team, and it's hit the side net, fortunately for me, and it stays 1-0 to Wrexham. And second, it's half-time here. Going to ask Blackmore, and I'm just going to encourage everyone, because I don't want to kind of leave anything to chance. Try and get them going again. Won't make any subs until probably the 60th or 70th minute. Just want to give them a chance to impress me here, because I am giving players a chance in this game, which I don't always do. It's difficult to do it, but when it's a long season like it is in the lower leagues, like the Premier League is 20 teams, 19 home games, 19 away games, you're playing 38 matches, whereas in the lower leagues you have 24 teams, you're playing 46 games, 23 home, 23 away. On top of that, with cup games, etc., etc., it's going to be a long old season. You can easily go 50, 60, 70 games, well, maybe not 70 at lower league, but you can easily go 50 or 60 games into a season, and it's difficult. So it's important that we rotate as much as we can. Decent ball in, looking for Gray. Oh, it's in. It's finally 2-0. Gray repays his faith as well. Excellent, excellent stuff by James Gray. Wes Yorkshire player, James Gray. Both the players that have been itching for a chance to impress me have both started and have both scored. Excellent stuff. I'm just going to passionately encourage my team just a little bit more. Try and get a third goal if possible. Kill the game off. Take the sting out of the game and go back to Wrexham with a great win in the FA Cup. That is what we're aiming for. Ball goes over the top. Cummins heads it back and Belford, my second choice reserve goalkeeper, can catch that nicely. And yeah, it's going well. 7.1 and 7 for the two strikers. Comes in. Ooh, chance here. Fox. York and Fox. Fox stays off. York can get the ball back for Wrexham. Gets a left foot across. It looks for Carrington and it's a save by Knight. And what is Knight going to do? It's just gonna skip. I always do that. I always go get ready to commentate and then it just skips to the next highlight. Okay, now it's gone. Let's make a change. We'll go a highlight coming over here. Who's tired? Oh, Cummings is a little bit tired. Madga Gomez is pretty damn tired as well. Haven't really got anybody. I mean, Carrington, I see he's not really suited to that position. Bring Rob Evans on, I suppose. I'll bring Blaine Hudson on for Cummins, and then I don't know what. I think I'm happy enough just to do that. Just do that, because I'm happy to give them, you know, quite a bit of time playing. Give them a full game if possible. I don't see the need to bring on like Jennings or any of my big players like Moke if I don't have to. And York's in again here. Can he finish it? Where's York? Oh, it's a good ball in, Logan. Oh, he should have done better perhaps. Got on target though. 2-0. Chance off a corner. Brister's to take the corner. Lays it in and Knight can save it. Stays 2-0 to Wrexham. And Samford substitute, they got Charles Gilbert on. Let's make a second change then. We've got 20 minutes to go. I am going to be bringing on, I think what I'll do, I'll drop Francis into midfield. He can play central midfield, but I there's better players there. And I'm going to bring on Rob Evans for him. Just make a slight change there. Try and bolster the midfield slightly. I did this a few weeks ago and it worked pretty well. So just going to do it again. An extra body back there in case they try to attack. Oh, and it's in Gomez. Madga Gomez. I think that's his first goal for us. Yeah, this is his first goal. The Liverpool player on loan from Liverpool at Wrexham. And it is 3-0. I'm not going to watch the replay again because you've obviously seen it. I'll only try to show the replays in highlight packages. Unless it's a really good goal, of course. Then obviously I will show it. But great stuff so far. Really happy with this. Gomez is getting tired though, so I may need to. I brought Evans on already though, haven't I? I can stay on. I think he can stay on. It's just let's just leave it like it is. There's no point tweaking things in case somebody gets injured or sent off or something. Just leave it with the two subs. There's no point doing it for the sake of it. 4 minutes to go. Evans plays it back to Gomez. Gomez ball forward finds Carrington. What can Carrington do? Plays it to Evans. Good ball to Gray. James Gray, good ball in. Logan! Finally, Logan does score and he makes it 4-0. And Gray turns provider. And he's had a great game, James Gray, to be fair. I thought he was... I thought he could hit a barn door earlier, the way he was shooting. He missed two sitters in the first half. I was thinking, oh my, it's going to be one of those days. But he's got a goal and an assist. Can't fault it. 8.4 performance. Matt Gomez got 8.8 performance as well. Overall, pretty happy with the strength and depth, but at this level at least. Obviously, if you were against a team like, I don't know, Bolton Wanderers or Bristol or Cardiff or somebody like the Championship, you know, it would be difficult. But at this level, it's kind of, you know, Stamford are like two divisions below us, so we should be beating them easily like we are anyway, to be fair. But, you know, football's a crazy game. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, sometimes you draw. And like I said, with Wrexham earlier beating Arsenal, shockers can happen in the Cup, but not today. We're playing pretty well, nice football. The players I brought in are playing well, and we're getting the job done, and that's all that matters. And there you have it, guys. Stamford 0, Wrexham 4. We win, we go through to the next round of the FA Cup. I'm just going to passionately tell them a very nice victory, well done, blah, blah, blah. Excellent stuff. I'm really, really happy with that. And there we have it. Just going to... Got £12,500 for qualifying in the English fourth qualifying round. It's actually a qualifying round that we were in. Had that wrong earlier. I do apologise for that. I want to just quickly show you the player that I'm scouting, Curtis March. He's on my shortlist. Let's just... oh, God, am I doing scouting? Shortlist. And then Curtis March. He's got a 3.5-star player. at Port Talbot at the moment. And if we show you his scout report here, it says he's as good as Madgar Gomez and Cody Francis, but he is also can play central midfielder and he's as good as the rest. He's can play an attacking, advanced playmaker, central midfielder. He's quite versatile. He would be interested in joining. But if you look at his history, he was at Cardiff originally, and then left to go to Swansea, but he never made an appearance for either of those two Welsh clubs. Went to Port Talbot in the Welsh Premier League, made 11 appearances, one goal. He got four assists as well, to be fair, so he's doing pretty well at that level. And I think he could be somebody I could bring in. He could be a good squad player, and he likes to play those positions that I'm trying to fill in that kind of centre role. So he's somebody that I am thinking of scouting a bit more and going for. But anyway, guys, I will be ending the episode here. I've been Dragonheart FM. Until next time, goodbye.